Hello, artists. Stephanie here, Concord, California. Gonna start out on the next section. Before I can cover these, I have to treat these with whatever I want to do, which we're gonna use the bags again. This got a little bit grungy, but you know, whatever treatment it'll be, it will definitely take down the whiteness of it. So this next section, I am just going to put on a movie so that I can be entertained somewhat while you guys are being entertained. I did look for some little girls. They don't have any little girls like this. They're really bizarre little, it's so strange. They didn't have young girls' clothing like they did have the little boys. So I wanted to put a girl on there because there should be a girl on there. I'll keep looking through the book and see if I find something that will work. But for now, we will leave that as it is. Okay, so we're going to cover this. And then my next step will be to figure out these things for each page. These will all get covered. And then we'll have to put, oh, so that's all the higher that goes up. Right to there, actually. Yeah, right about to there. So we'll put a stopper on that so it doesn't go up that high. I'll find a little metal piece, maybe with a brad. I think that'd be kind of cool. I might also look at doing some sort of loopy thing here. I think that might be worthwhile to try. These will get covered with paper. So it will be something like that. Okie doke. There's a concern here for me. I don't know about for you, but for me, there's a concern of making sure that there's enough space for it to move. I think there will be. I don't think I'll have to put another spacer in here. I was thinking about putting like a stir stick, you know, the coffee stir stick. They're super thin. You know, I could build it up one more level if I needed to, but I think we're okay without it. I think we'll be all right. Okay, so here we go. We'll see you guys later, and enjoy me pasting some paper onto parts, right? Okay, and the big thing here also is not to get mixed up with what is what. I have to do both sides. Okay? All right. We shall chat soon. Okay.
Thank you. you talk all the time, you'll never hear what anybody else has to say. And therefore, all you'll have to talk about is your own conversation. The same is true for people who think all the time. That means, when I use the word think, talking to yourself, subvocal conversation, the constant chit-chat of symbols and images and talk and words inside your skull. Now, if you do that all the time, you'll find that you've nothing to think about except thinking. And just as you have to stop talking to hear what others have to say, you have to stop thinking to find out what life is about. And the moment you stop thinking, you become into immediate contact with the unspeakable world. The force of liberation will blow the world to pieces.
Thank you.
I gotta let it dry. This is a perfect time to stop here. Hopefully the show stops here. Hold on. Okay. Wow. Well, we are painted. I wanted something very vintage. I wanted something that looked dirty and grungy, and I'll edge everything with the timber brown again. This was what I was looking for. A little bit of sunlight on top. The iridescence of the bronze will help. I will be putting most likely circus posters over the top of these. I think that would look really cool. And I have some that I've printed off the internet. We are all painted up here. And hopefully our tape is still doing okay here. And hopefully we have good enough movement. I will most likely be covering those with some wax. Tim Holtz has a distress glaze, and maybe that will help to set the paint as well as make it slipperier. What else do I know? I probably should have painted the foldouts. That's because remember I'm going to have two or three pop-ups. These are not painted. Should do that real fast. So I am painting all over my book. This is another book that I will make into an altered book at a later date. Try not to paint all over everything too much. Okay, so we had the bronze. I'm going to do one more piece in here. A couple more pieces because I don't know what it's going to take. This bronze goes quite a ways. I wish the sprayer would work, but it doesn't. So, do what you gotta do. Alright, after I paint this, I think I'm gonna try to be done for the day. You know, I wanted to get this layout finished, but, you know, there's no way to get this whole thing finished, of course. I just wanted to get it done. I've worked on it all day. Dang it. It's nuts. How do I do this? Why do I always choose something that takes days to complete? Oh my gosh. It will be super cool when it's done. I know that. You know, we're heading that way pretty quick. To like the, oh my gosh, what the heck is she creating? Okay, and then I put some tattered rose on here to dilute it. You put tattered rose on it without the Mod Podge. It looks like it just kind of darkens it down here. So, that's probably not very good. Sunshine on there. And since these ones will be out in the front, I probably actually don't even have to put the other colors on at this point. I want them to come out in front of these guys, so if they are a lighter color, they will come out in front. Now just do the light properties and such like that. Important things that we realize when we're making stuff. different tones make a difference as to our different shades, colors. And that one turned really brown. That one's very bronzy. Now, this is all water soluble, so when I put when I glue this onto the backing for the fold out, for the pop out, we're gonna have movement. We're gonna have movement. That glittery bronze is gonna get everywhere. But we're gonna just go with that for now. I think that'll be good. Thanks for joining up with me today. I'll get the other video out. It should be ready to upload into YouTube. And I'm going to give it a spray of this. Because I love this color. Stop there. Stop. Put it down. Put down the spritz. No. Okay, everybody. Again, thank you so much for watching. Please hit that like and subscribe button. I know I've just been kind of flying through these pages here today, these videos. Just working away. I like to let you see what I'm making. I do not sit there and do a step-by-step instruction video. That's not my style. All of you new people that have subscribed, I'm so happy to see you here. But again, I'm not a step-by-step person. I don't want you to necessarily copy what I'm doing. I would love for you to attempt to do your own circus or castle, or, you know, hopefully this inspires you to really push the boundaries on whatever you're creating. You know, I think that's the important part of being a teacher for me, is to show you what you can do. And kind of let you learn by osmosis, right? Yeah. Oh boy, guys, I'm tired, but I think I made it to 8:30, so I'm going to take a break, and since I've been up since 2:00, I need it, and hopefully I can sleep well, so. All right, everybody, you have a great night, and you take care of yourselves, and have a nice Sunday tomorrow, and I'm sure you'll see me again soon. Alrighty. Bye. Oh.